Hello and welcome to the program. On May 16, Ukrainians all over the world celebrate the day of the national embroidered shirt called Vyshyvanka. This event has turned into a global cultural diplomacy opportunity, as on this day, Ukrainians wear Vyshyvankas to demonstrate adherence to the idea of national identity. To talk more about Ukrainian Vyshyvanka and the art of embroidery, we're joined in the studio today by Tetiana Protcheva. She's a Ukrainian master of embroidery and designer who created a new embroidery style called Glow Art. Hello and thank you for being with us today. So first for the viewers to understand, let's talk about the Vyshyvanka itself. It is a traditional embroidery style deeply rooted in Ukrainian culture. Can you tell us more about this art?
Ukrainian embroidery, it's like a nationality code. Mm-hmm. When people make some design, master put information, some information, mm-hmm. what she want put in this picture or some. And I want to say about a new direction in mm-hmm. embroidery, mm-hmm. glow art. Mm-hmm. It's embroidery glow in the dark.
Okay.
It's really interesting, but I was in a different country. I was mm-hmm. in Australia, Brasilia, China, Japan, and when I show my embroidery with mm-hmm. glow art, it's really interesting mm-hmm. for people. For example, this Cheshire cat in the dark glowing. Mm-hmm. Last week I was in London and show my accessoire, this bag, in cat show.
Mm-hmm. So to come back to Vyshyvanka, since, let's say, 5 years, you went to London, you went to Japan, you went to this country, they are interested into this Ukrainian embroidery. Why do you think it works now in Western countries? Why do you think they are interested in Vyshyvankas?
Ukraine traditional design have like protect and looks very nice. Mm-hmm. And for example, red and white, red and black color. It's a color from central region, if you, in from Ukraine. Mm-hmm. It looks very interesting and looks good. And like protect.
So how hard for a Ukrainian designer who does Vyshyvanka, how hard it is, what is the challenge to get into international market? What is the obstacle?
It's individual, everything individual. Mm-hmm. If people have interest in a new idea for young people, it's really easy. Mm-hmm. I show my embroidery and around the wall and people like it. It's easy.
So it's that easy to get into fashion, basically. Okay, so let's talk a little bit more about your project. How did you come with the idea of glow art? Because you could have just, you know, modernized the basic embroidery, but you came with the idea of embroidery glowing in the dark. Why the idea?
I have a high mechanical education, mm-hmm. and I like make a mix traditional Ukrainian embroidery and new innovation. Mm-hmm. And in Japan exhibition Expo 2005, one lady gave me present, a special thread glow in the dark.
Okay.
And I to start using this special thread in picture with a Bible theme, mm-hmm. and then I start using in accessoire. And I open three new direction in embroidery. The first, glow art, mm-hmm. it's embroidery glow in the dark. Next, digital needlework. Mm-hmm. I won't show how it's working. For example, this bag, mm-hmm. When we scan in mobile,
mm-hmm. So basically the anthem of Ukraine, basically.
Mm. It's also my idea. Mm-hmm. I call it a digital needlework. Mm-hmm. And next, new direction in embroidery, it's a palimpsest.
Okay.
This very old tower mm-hmm. with old embroidery. I make a QR code. Okay. I find same color like old thread. And here, I in this QR code, I put information, image information about our country. When you scan in, mm-hmm. you can look clothes, Ukraine clothes, Ukraine food.
So it's some sort of a I wouldn't say business card, but it's some sort of encyclopedia also for Ukrainian culture throughout the ancient art of embroidery. Now, do you have other projects? Do you have other markets you want to get in? Do you have other projects than Glow Out and all your projects here?
My idea open Glow Gallery mm-hmm. in different country. Now I have a gallery in Israel, in Barcelona, and we speak with people, open Glow Art Gallery in London.
And is it only Ukrainians who buy it, or people interested in Ukraine, or how does it work? Is it just they find it, you know, pretty and they buy it, or is it usually the Ukrainian diaspora who just buys it?
No, it's interesting for international people. For example, people who have company, I mm-hmm. make a QR code mm-hmm. With this company, like.
Kind of,
here
yeah.
mm-hmm. and when we scan and people can look about company, it's mm-hmm. an interesting mm-hmm. idea, not just Ukraine people.
Well, thank you very much. It was a pleasure to have you in the studio to talk about your global project. And Vyshyvanka is in Ukrainian embroidery today in our studio. That was Tetiana Protcheva, Ukrainian master of embroidery. Stay tuned for the rest.